Imagine it's late at night, or maybe even early in the morning, you're sitting looking at your phone, watching some really fun TikTok or Instagram reels, and all of a sudden you start getting all of these alerts from Apple saying, "Click here if you would like to reset your password." And it's happening so frequently and so often you can't even get through the next funny cat video. Little disconcerting, I am sure. But if you would like those alerts to just stop, maybe you might be tempted to just do the password reset thing. There must be something wrong at Apple. Well, something is wrong at Apple. Something is wrong with your account, and you may be under an MFA attack. In this video, we're going to talk about what an MFA attack is, what's been happening to other people, and how to recognize this and defend yourself if something like this were to happen for you. If you're new here, my name is Kathy Zant. I do security videos so you know what attacks hackers are up to so you can better protect yourself. Let's get into the article and see exactly what's been happening. And this article was published in Krebs on Security. Brian Krebs has been a security reporter for a very long time. This article is from late March 2024. And he noted that several Apple customers were reporting being targeted in these elaborate phishing attacks involving what appears to be a bug in Apple's password reset feature. So in the scenario, which you can see over here in the screenshot, a person's Apple devices are forced to display dozens of system-level prompts that prevent the devices from being used until the recipient responds allow or don't allow to each prompt. Now, assuming that this user manages not to accidentally hit the wrong button and allow that password reset to happen, scammers will then call the victims, spoofing the Apple support caller ID, saying that the user's account is under attack and Apple support needs to verify a one-time code. Brian Krebs reports that a number of users had reached out to him that this was happening to them. The first was Parth Patel, an entrepreneur who's building a startup in the conversational AI space, and he mentioned on Twitter that a recent phishing campaign was targeting him with a push bombing or an MFA fatigue attack. The attacker was sending multiple password reset requests to the iPhone in question here. Patel said that all of his devices started blowing up, his watch, laptop, and phone. It was like the system notification from Apple to approve, but I couldn't do anything else with my phone. I had to go through and decline 100 plus notifications. Now, some people who might be confronted with something like this might eventually click allow just to make it stop. The attackers in this campaign had an ace up their sleeves. They said they were spoofing a call from the actual Apple support phone number. So the actual number displayed was Apple's real customer support line. So he picked up and he's, of course, suspicious. And they asked if they could verify some information. So the ultimate goal of what these attackers are trying to do is to trigger an Apple ID reset code to be sent to the user's device, which is a text message including a one-time password. If the user supplies that one-time code, the attackers can then reset the password on the account and lock that user out of their Apple account. They can also then remotely wipe all of the user's Apple devices. Now, from what we can tell here, the phone number is key. We have another person reporting that this happened to them. Chris is a cryptocurrency hedge fund owner, asked that only his first name be used. He doesn't want to be a target. Not surprising there. So they persisted hitting all of the devices with these reset notifications for several days. And then at one point, he received that suspicious phone call on his iPhone saying it was from Apple support. So if you get a call like this and they say that they are support, hang up and call them back because they are spoofing that number on the caller ID. So they called back to the real Apple, and of course, Apple said that they don't do that. They don't call you asking for information unless you request that they call. Chris was freaking out that someone was basically trying to hijack his entire digital life. It definitely looked that way. So he changed all of his passwords and went to an Apple store to buy a new iPhone. and then created a new Apple iCloud account using a brand new email address. But because the cell phone number was still tied to that Apple account, the attacks were continuing. Now, Ken here is a security industry veteran wanting to be anonymous and said that this happened to them in the middle of the night at 12:30 a.m. And even though this person had their Apple Watch set to remain quiet during that time, it woke him up with one of these alerts. And when you get some of these alerts on your Apple Watch, sometimes you have to scroll to find that don't allow, which, you know, it's very easy to click allow by accident. So that's a little bit freaky. So he contacted Apple support and was escalated to a senior Apple engineer. That engineer then turned on Apple recovery key, which would stop these notifications once and for all. Now, these recovery keys are not for everyone. It's an optional security feature that helps improve security of Apple IDs. It's a randomly generated 28-character code, and if you lose it, you lose your Apple account. So it's not something that you want to set up if you do not have some safe way to store that 28-character code. So he did go and enable a recovery key for his account as instructed, but it's not stopping the system alerts from appearing on all of his devices every few days. So Krebs on Security tested that experience and confirmed that enabling a recovery key does nothing to stop a password reset prompt from being sent to associated Apple devices. So how are they doing this? They're basically going to iforgot.apple.com, which asks for an email address and for the visitor to solve a CAPTCHA. And once that is done, the page will display the last two digits of the phone number tied to the Apple account. So you fill in the missing digits and hit submit on the form, and it sends a system alert whether or not a user has enabled an Apple recovery key. So obviously, rate limiting these types of attacks would be a good thing. Now, MFA bombing attacks are not something new. We're just now seeing this targeting users of Apple devices. Throughout 2022, there was a criminal hacking group that used MFA bombing for intrusions at Cisco, Microsoft, and Uber. In response, Microsoft heightened their security. Now, Kishan Bagaria is a hobbyist security researcher and engineer, founded the website Texts, which is now owned by Automattic, the owner of WordPress.com. And he says that Apple has a problem on their hands. He said that he reported to Apple a bug that allowed an exploit called AirDOS because it could be used to let an attacker infinitely spam all near iOS devices with a system level prompt to share a file via AirDrop, which is a file sharing capability built into Apple products. Apple fixed that bug 4 months later and thanked Bagaria in the Associated Security Bulletin. Now, of course, you probably are wondering, what can you do? Now, this is where using your single email address everywhere and your single cell phone number everywhere becomes a problem. If an attacker decides that you are a target that they would like to get into your Apple system, they can do some searching. They can even go through previous breaches. They can go to Have I Been Pwned and see if your email address has ever been in a breach. They don't go to Have I Been Pwned. They just go to these random databases that you can even find on GitHub of random passwords and usernames that have been found in breaches. But they will find these in various hacker forums, and they will find an email address, a phone number, and they will use these to do an MFA bombing attack. However, if you are using an email address that you aren't using elsewhere, an email address that is only set up for Apple, it would be much harder to guess. So you can set up a specific email address with something other than Gmail and keep that private and have something associated that's only Apple. For example, if you have a domain name like zant.com, my email address is kathy@zant.com. If I set up Apple at zant.com, I don't do this. I do something else. But if I did that, I could use that as one of my obfuscated email addresses that would be harder to guess because I'm only using that email address with that provider, with Apple. So it would be much harder to guess. Secondly, I could set up a VoIP, a voice over IP. I could use Google Voice or a service like that for an alternate phone number that can receive SMS and use that with Apple and keep that separate from my phone number that apparently is everywhere. So you can do these types of things for accounts that are incredibly important to you. You have consumer accounts where you are using a standard email address that you don't care if it's discovered by anyone in a malicious way. You have a phone number that you're using like that, and then you have a private cell phone number. You have a private email address that you are using for things like your bank, for your cellular provider to protect against SIM swap attacks, for Apple, which is also tied to so many things that you're doing as one of those catch-all things, like they could take over your iCloud account if they were able to get into your Apple account, those types of things. So this is a very interesting attack that attackers are using to try to take over Apple accounts for nefarious purposes. These seem to be very targeted attacks for high-profile individuals, but think about it. I didn't know who any of these people were. Maybe I would know them if I knew what their actual names were, but they are not heads of state. They are not heads, CEOs of major corporations. If you are in a position where you might be targeted, maybe you write or talk about cryptocurrency in public forums, and they could tie the fact that you have cryptocurrency to your phone number, to your email address. If you are talking about any other types of assets that you have, you are putting yourself out there as a possible victim. It's time for you to start guarding your privacy, start guarding your privacy, guarding the privacy of your phone numbers, your email addresses. I've got some other links down below about SIM swap attacks, as well as why you shouldn't be using a single email address for everything. If this video helped you think about security in a new way, and if you are going to take some action, give us a like down below and subscribe for more content like this. You can also go read that Brian Krebs article if you want to dive deeper, but just be aware if password reset notifications start showing up on your Apple devices, you too might be a victim of an attack like this. Thanks for watching.